in January. So I would pay attention to the year-over-year numbers. If those start going negative, it will be the first inclination that you have a market that could get challenging, okay? We're gonna go over some other charts because sometimes these numbers kind of get, you kind of think, okay, gosh, that was a bad year. Are you concerned about business in general? Because that's the sense I'm getting everywhere. Okay, so let's compare how bad 2018 was to a bad year. And how I figure out we're gonna have a bad year is this affordability chart. When we get to 17% affordability, there's usually a reaction. Not usually, there's always a reaction that's negative inside of 2 years. And not a little negative, extremely negative. Now, where are we at in affordability right now? We're at 28%. We're nowhere close to 17. So what's interesting about this market is that for the first time at 28% affordability, we have slowing sales. We normally have exploding sales. We normally have exploding prices. We have full employment. We have no foreclosures in the mix of the marketplace. How many of you are REO agents right now? I mean, with what? What inventory? I mean, it's non-existent. So this is a very unusual set of charts to have no price gains, to not have construction booming. And I've been saying this for 18 months, and I finally started listening to myself, and I thought, we're not supposed to be here, but we are. We have this wonderful set of charts, and we're going nowhere. That concerns me, because what if the charts turn negative? Is 4% unemployment normal? No. Would we consider 5.5% unemployment terrible, or would that still be pretty decent? It's still pretty decent, except for it's more than where it is right now. So could that slight change have a negative impact on price? So what I'm saying is 28% affordability could be the new 17. And why would that happen? Can you have lending so restrictive that you can't get people approved? You would know that better than I. You either have people that really aren't interested in real estate, or they're interested and they can't buy it. Every year we have an event at the Nixon Library. It's a charity event, and on a panel we'll have people like the president of the Mortgage Bankers Association and the Fannie Mae chief economist, Doug Duncan, etc. And always ask them, what's the mood of the marketplace? Is lending going to get a lot more lax, that type of thing? And the ratios, as you know, are pretty aggressive, but you still have to have a job and you still have to have credit and all that. And those differences impact how many people can buy. And I think that may be what's still going on. And talking to the Mortgage Bankers Association, lenders are still afraid they're going to buy back the next loan. They're cross every T, dot every I, and if it really is a little scary to them, they want to pass. And so that's still in the marketplace. So affordability at 27%. So let's take a look at some reactions when affordability, by the way, this is an hour and a half talk that I'm going to be doing in a half hour. So I'm gonna cut some of the things out and I'll just verbally say them. So this is a chart in red, what happens to unsold inventory within 2 years of hitting 17% affordability. We hit it in 1980, we hit it in 89, we hit it in 2005. So let's take a look at the actual numbers. Unsold inventory, 1980, was it 6 months? And then it went to 22 months in 2 years. By the way, would you like to know that was gonna happen in advance? Yes. The only chart I know that gives you an indication is that affordability chart. Unsold inventory in the 89 to 91 went from 5 to 13. Unsold inventory went from 2.5 months to 9 months, 2005 to 2008. And inventory exploded in 2017 to 2018, 3.1 months to 3.7. Am I making fun of 2018? Kind of. So I want you to put it in perspective. 2018 was not our first bad year. 2019, we'll have to see. But it's one thing it's not going to have, it's not going to be dominated by foreclosures this time, and that's a big deal. Trustees' deeds. Trustees' deeds, right after, look at 1980 and then 83, 1989 to 1996 even went up, exploded in 2006 and 7 and 8. So here are the numbers there. Trustee sales increased 814% in the 80s, 406% in the 90s, and all the way up to 900%, 1600% in the latest downturn. And trustee sales decreased 7758 to 6100 from 2017 to 2018. So you had trustee sales go down in this terrible year of 2018, okay? Construction, new homes. This is an interesting chart. Normally, that gold line is affordability all the way at the bottom at 17%. Strange thing, it usually pairs itself with the highest construction year. So take a look at 1989. That's new homes built. So just when it's most unaffordable, the builders build everything they can. They're the worst timing experts in the world. And how does that happen? Because it's very difficult to pull the plug on something that's working. In 1988, you build a track of homes, and it's all sold out. In 2005, you build a track of homes, and people are camping out to buy your stuff. How do you have a meeting at your company when everything's going crazy, and you say, you know what, we're going to wrap stuff up. We're going to sell all our lots and all our model homes, and we're going to sell all our projects, and we'll buy them back. In about 2 years at 10 cents on the dollar. That would be a tough meeting to have. It's exactly the kind of meeting they should have had. I debated in 2006 in front of them and said you should do that, but I can understand how they couldn't pull it off. But what's interesting is we now have construction, and it's an interesting perspective. Last time I spoke at the meeting last year, Lance Martin opened the meeting saying, construction is booming and it's back. And that's why I like charts, because how it feels in reality is different. So there's the chart of 2018 construction for single family. It's booming to the extent that we are now building the same amount of homes that we did in 1981 when interest rates were 20.5% for construction loans. Is that a boom in single family construction? No. Booms look like those other charts, 160,000 units. We're building 60,000 units, and you know what? If a builder thought they could build 160,000 houses in California profitably, they'd be doing it. They don't think they can, obviously, or they would do it. So here are the numbers for construction.